I'm really interested in the neurons in the cervical spinal cord up in your neck that control the diaphragm and control breathing. And I'm one of a few people in the world, actually, who's looking at strengthening those connections from the brainstem to those neurons in order to help people with spinal cord injury after the connections have become damaged or weakened. What I'm really excited about here at UF is the ability to collaborate with the engineers on campus. They bring their expertise with materials science and electrode design, and I bring my expertise with neuron function, and we're coming up with some really great results to restore breathing. I started off wanting to be a paleontologist, oceanographer, then primatologist, and my parents really encouraged me to follow all these paths. So I did some research in Panama studying howler monkeys. I worked at the San Diego Zoo in the nursery raising baby animals. I even went to vet school thinking that was gonna be my route. For a small moment in time, I was maybe gonna be a magician. My father is a professional magician and we used to perform in Vegas. I'm the type of person that wants to know the whys and hows of everything. And it really dawned on me that being a scientist was probably the best career choice for me. Receiving this award was honestly a little bit of a shock to me. I was really surprised and quite humbled. And I just feel really grateful to be recognized for this. And also want to just thank everybody who was a part of this. I truly believe that I got here not because I'm amazing or did anything incredibly impressive, but just that I didn't give up. If you find something that you're passionate about, interested in, you don't take the no's to heart. You just keep going. It's this sense of being anti-fragile, going through a storm and becoming stronger on the way out.